Welcome back. So while I'm waiting for my batteries to turn up, I was going to go over some other bits and pieces that are available in the WLED software, and it's the ability to control the light from outside your network. So you've got the standard UI which comes with it. So you just browse to the IP address of the light, and it comes up with this, which is great. You can do anything you want in there as far as controlling light patterns and that sort of thing. So a quick demo. Turn it on. If we choose, I'm not sure it's connected yet. Solid changes it to a solid color. Dozens of patterns in here. You can change it to whatever you want, so solid, and choose the color. It changes it as we go. So it's brilliant if you you're in your network, but if you're outside your network and you want to control the light for whatever reason, turning on lights to the driveway or something, it gets a bit more sort of complicated. I mean, you could open up ports on your firewall and have a dynamic DNS or something and, you know, let all the nasties in, or you can use another service. So the one we're going to cover today is what it said in the title, is MQTT, which is a service developed by IBM back in the day, and it's sort of a subscription service. So the software on the light constantly checks the URL for either data or to send data to. A quick explanation for my YouTube channel. You've obviously come to my URL, both of you, and clicked on subscribe. So you subscribe to the service, right? So every time I post a video, it lets you know about it. Same thing for the MQTT. You're creating a URL for the software to ping constantly, and it checks to see if there's any changes or sends data to that URL. So it's a specific type of server to do that. It's an MQTT server or a broker. You can use free versions of it you can load, but then you need a server to load it on. But for this example, we're just going to use the Adafruit one. It's free for you to use, and we'll just go through the configuration of that, so you can get some basic controls up and running with your light if you wanted to. So what you'll need is a subscription to or an account on Adafruit IO. So just go to io.adafruit.com. I've already got one sorted out, so I'll just log in there and make the changes. So when you first go in, you've got some demo dashboards and demo feeds. We want to create a new feed, which is what the light will be looking at, and I don't know why, but there's no plus button here. You've got to go into view all and then new feed, right? So let's create this after the name of this lamp, which will be LED01. And just click into that. And now that's created, it gives us the MQTT endpoint to put into the lamp. So I'll just copy that and go into my lamp. And under config, we've got sync interfaces. And we'll scroll down to MQTT. Tick the box to make sure it's enabled. So what we just copied was the device topic. So I just put that into there. And then for this one, we have to put something in, otherwise it'll complain. So I'll just put in all. So once the broker, and that's just the io.adafruit.com. and it wants the username and password. So if we pop back into the Adafruit website, we've got my key. So this is my burner account, so you know, do all damage you like, it's not going to be there by the time this video is published. Let me choose our username, and this is the password it wants to log in. Save. So for that to work, we need to reboot the lamp. So I've removed the button, so it's just to unplug and unplug back in again. So technically the MQTT is configured. So how do we turn it on? We go back into Adafruit, go to our dashboards. Again, there's no plus to add a new dashboard, so we go view all, new dashboard, and we'll just call this WLED control. Create. And there's the blank dashboard. Up here is the button you want to click on to create a new, it says a new block, but I'm just going to, it creates a new button. To create a new button, we're just going to turn the light on and off. Choose our LED01 feed. And then within the LED settings, WLED settings, it has the the guide basically to how to control the light. And in here, the settings are either on or off, or you've got toggle as well. So I'm just going to turn this light on and off, that's all I'm interested in. So in the controls, I'm going to type in on and off to set those button values, and then create the block. So now we've got an on off button. So if we click on it, it goes on and off. So if we look at the light, goes on and off. But who cares, right? Because you can do that in the UI of the lamp. You can turn it on and off. Same thing. But of course with the Adafruit MQTT service, you can do it from anywhere in the world. So if you're not at home, you can just browse into the dashboard from your phone and turn the light on or off. So the other setting we can create is we can adjust the brightness. But we'll best to do that with the effects on solid. So we're on solid red. We'll create a new block. And it'll be a slider, same feed, except, and it's got slider min value of 0, which is right, and max value of 100. But if we look at the docs, the max value can actually be 255. So we'll put that in. So we've got a new block. So if we set this to maximum, the light should go full brightness, halfway, it starts dimming. Yep. Until you can turn it off. So if you control the lamp through the UI tool, it overrides obviously the Adafruit, and that's why it's, this says it's off, but we've actually already turned on. So I click this on, it'll stay on, and if I click it again, it'll turn off. Pretty straightforward. It's also available in the docs as setting specific colors, but in the API, I haven't figured out how to do that yet. So if you know how to do it, by all means, leave some comments below, but I can't figure out how to add the ability to change the color or the API, because once you've got those, obviously It opens up the whole world of things you can do from with the light, sort of remotely. So that's the crux of using MQTT. It's pretty easy to use with Adafruit, just a couple of mouse clicks and you're up and running. So in the next video, what we'll be going through is using Google Assistant. So you'll be saying, okay, Google, turn on the light remotely as well, because Google doesn't connect directly to MQTT. You've got to go through something like IFTTT. It's complicated, but you can sort of tell Google to tell IFTTT to tell MQTT to turn it on and come back again. But we'll leave that for the next video. Thanks for watching.